Sir, since AI is evolving continuously, do you think there can be a time when AI can develop rational and empathy at the same time?
Honestly, I don't think AI can ever be as human as humans are. AI is only going to be logical. It is what patterns we have seen in the past, what logic has been used in the past is what AI can do. I think the notion that AI will replace humans and have empathy, have compassion is not going to happen. I think humans are going to be required to make that judgment call. Thanks.
Good afternoon, sir. How would you address any concerns of your employees who are worried about losing their jobs due to AI becoming a reality?
So I'll divide this into two parts. One is how are we going to display our will and how are we going to gain the skills. So will and skills are those two parts. Will is all about how much hunger we have for the learning. And the second part of will is that do we really know how to learn? So learning itself is a big block. Now there's multiple ways. There are microbyte learning, there is experiential learning. How do you yourself, you know, equip with these learnings? It is very important in today's scenario. Job, nature of job is going to be very, very different now because there are 70% of current jobs which might get obsolete in next 20 years. Even there's a Deloitte report which says that around 30% jobs of 2010 has already gone obsolete. So it is definitely one disturbing news for the employees. However, on the other side, there are opportunities coming up with the new technologies. We have come up with new departments in the team. Second part of the will is having the hunger to stay relevant in the societies of today's time. And this hunger will come from your own inquisitiveness. So the time any employee is asking me the question about it, I always say that, do you have enough hunger to stay afloat in today's time or not? We say that it is a VUCA time. There are only 5 years of life to any particular skill set which is coming up now. You need to have that eye and wisdom to figure out that what is going to be your next learning path. When we say skill, it is about knowing the market needs, getting closer to the problem and understanding that what are the new things coming up and do you know it or not. Once you know about that skills, the second thing is that how fast and efficient mastery you are getting over it. It is not about just knowing the art, it is about practicing the art. If you have practice enough, you would know that what are the possibilities of that particular skill and how can you use in your future of work. So overall, skill and will both have to be balanced to find a solution for this question. And I see that future of employee is not going to be seen as by the age, it will be seen by the adaptability and flexibility of the individuals.
Good afternoon, sir. I would just like to ask you a question. What is the future of AI bots today?
Okay, that's a great question. See, in terms of the bots, there are, you know, multiple types of bots which are going to be available in an enterprise. If you're looking at conversational AI, there are various chat bots, speech bots, which are active across various channels in the enterprise. And they are actually going to shape up how the organization or the brand is interacting with the customers. Both at a, you know, every stakeholder level, there is going to be one interface which is going to be more conversational based. Second, AI bots are extremely effective in automating your processes. So I think, you know, those bots have a very important role to play in how the organizations can be much more productive as we move along. So there is a huge, you know, work which is going around in this particular area. And I feel that, you know, it is going to be much more important and significant for all organizations of future.
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'd like to ask you a question. How do you think MBA graduates can be ready in this business which will be driven by AI?
So, like I pointed out earlier, that AI is going to be an imperative and you have to adopt this technology or those businesses who don't evolve to it are ready to perish. Now, as MBA graduates, you need to look at various dimensions of this problem. I think the first thing you need to do is actually hone your, you know, observation talents to actually see how an existing business can be transformed to include AI in its business processes. Then you also need to find out new processes that can be adopted by this business so that it can become AI enabled. Thirdly, you really need to put in a lot of thought on how you are going to transform your workforce. So one of the first things that you will need to do there is to actually have a very fine-grained database of all the skills that your workforce has. Make a match of your needs with the skills of this workforce. Do a gap analysis, find out what is the upskilling that is required. Also, one thing that could be considered, if you really want to get professional about it, you can use psychometric techniques to identify and profile people's abilities and capabilities and how it would suit your various business processes which are going to be AI enabled.